I am Abdul Rajak Sarkar, Associate Professor, Department of English, Cambrian College, Dhaka. My dear students, and here you can see the name of the topic, modifiers, and it is lecture number 5. As I have told you that we have already completed the topic on 4 classes, and there we got some informations that modifiers need some rules. Those rules are divided into 5 classes, and we have already learned a number of rules, and today we will learn the remaining rules on that topic. This topic has certain purpose, and after completing that lesson you will be able to define what is modifier, then identify modifiers, it will be possible for you, and not only that, you will be able to use modifiers in different situations. Here, my dear students, look, rules for modifiers. And here you have some name like clause, adjective clause, adverb clause, linking verbs, action verbs, bad or badly. These are rules which will be needed when you will get any questions on modifier. If you want to solve it, you will have to know what is clause, and then other clauses like adjective clause, adverb clause, linking verbs and action verbs. Let us start our class. Here, what can you see? In this slide you can see what are modifiers. Actually, here clauses, we are going to discuss clauses. What is clause? Let us see the definition. A clause is a word group that contains a verb and its subject. And you know, in modifier, clause and phrase, these two terms are very important here. And we have already learned about different phrases in our previous classes, and today we are learning about clauses. And here you have got the definition. What is clause? Clause is a group of words, and in that group of words you will get a verb and you will get a subject here that will give you a meaning. It is a part of a sentence, it is not the whole sentence, but it will play the role of modifier. Look here, here you can see the balls, tennis ball, and from here we have designed a sentence like that, Rahi plays tennis. Look at the part of the sentence, and sometimes it is better to know that clause sometimes can be a complete sentence. Though we are calling that clause is a part of sentence, but sometimes clause can be a sentence. And here look, Rahi plays tennis. Here you have Rahi subject, plays, verb, then tennis, object. So it is a complete sentence. But I have written it as a part of the sentence. How? Rahi plays tennis whenever he can find the time. Rahi plays tennis whenever he can find the time. And here we have divided the sentence. This is the whole, the two parts collectively made here a sentence. And here Rahi plays tennis, it is one part, and whenever he can find the time, it is another part. And here look, Rahi subject, then plays verb, and now in this part look, he is here subject, can find verb, and this whole part, Rahi plays tennis. Rahi plays tennis, it is part of a sentence. And now this whole part is called a clause. Similarly, here, whenever he can find the time, it is a clause in that sense that a clause is a part of sentences. And we are just learning about clause, and after that we will learn about adjective clause, adverb clause and others. Look here. Explanation. Tennis is the sport, part of a sentence. And if you do not write other part, then it is a sentence. As we have told that clause can also be a complete sentence. Tennis is the sport. Here, tennis is subject, is here verb, and other part. Look, that Rahi likes best. Tennis is the sport that Rahi likes best. Two part of a full sentence. And is part carries subject and verb, which was in the definition. Group of words containing a verb and a subject. Here you have. So it is a clause. And here in this part, Rahi is subject and likes is your verb, and what is the conclusion? Tennis is the sport. In this sentence, this is the clause, and in this sentence, this is the clause. My dear students, I hope now it is clear to you what is clause. Let us move to our next slide, and here you have adjective clauses. And in your examination, your examiner will ask in the question paper that use adjective clause, use adverb clause to pre-modify or post-modify this and that. And if you don't know what is clause, then what is adjective clause, then it would not be possible for you. We are learning adjective clause. Here, an adjective clause is a subordinate clause that modifies a noun or pronoun. Adjective clause, subordinate clause, not principal clause, the subordinate clause. And it will give you extra information about noun or pronoun. How will it give the extra information? Look at the picture, and from here, look at that sentence. Mahi, who plays guard, scored 9 points. Here, Mahi, comma, who plays guard, scored 9 points. In this sentence, here, this part, who plays guard, adjective clause. Because here, it is giving extra information about the noun or pronoun of that sentences, who plays guard. And then look, here, this is noun, and here, adjective clause is who plays guard. Then adjective clause is modifying Mahi. According to the definition, adjective clause will give you extra information about the noun or pronoun of that sentence. And here Mahi is subject and it is noun, and it is modified by who plays guard. So who plays guard is adjective clause. And here, in this sentence, look at the poster that I bought. Look at the poster. Poster is in different color, in red color, that I bought. Here, that I bought. This is adjective clause. Why this is adjective clause? Try to be clear from here. Here, noun is poster. Which poster? That I bought. Not any other poster, only that poster which I bought. That means poster is modified here by the word group that I bought. So adjective clause that I bought is modifying here the noun poster. Look here, adjective clause modifies poster, that noun. In our next slide, here you have more information about adjective clause. You will get some information, and here you have some tips also. Adjective clauses are often introduced by a relative pronoun. Sometimes it is very difficult to bring or write some adjective clauses. From that situation, you can get the idea that generally adjective clause carry who, whom, whose, which, or that. Sometimes the relative pronoun is left out. Sometimes you will not see the presence of relative pronoun in adjective clauses. Exception may be there, but generally you will get who, whom, whose, which, or that when you will write any adjective clause. Look here. Here is the book that you wanted. Here is the book that you wanted. This part that you wanted. And here you have that. And here is the book. And here it is told that sometimes the relative pronoun is left. That means you can write also, here is the book you wanted. That will also be right. My dear students, so here that you wanted, it is adjective clause because it is giving extra information about here is the book, that one. In this slide, you have adverb clauses. What is adverb clauses? In previous slide, you have read about adjective clause and now you are reading adverb clause. An adverb clause is a subordinate clause. It is also subordinate clause, not principal clause, that modifies a verb. It will not modify noun or pronoun. It will modify a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. That means adverb clause will do the function of modifying a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. Look here, look at the picture. And we are writing from here, I eat breakfast. I eat breakfast. It is here verb. And other part of it, before I take my shower. I eat breakfast before I take my shower. And from here, we are getting the information that it is here verb. Then, when I am asking the question, you can ask the question by using when, before I take my shower, this time. And here, why? And these are your best common tips which will help you to find out adverb clause. If you ask question by using when or why or how, and you will get the answer, that answer will be adverb clause. These are the easiest way to find out adverb clause. Here, under what condition? This is another tips. When, why, how, under what condition? Here, it is adverb clause, and it will give the answer of the question by when. When do you take your breakfast? Before I take my shower. So here, before I take my shower is adverb clause. Here it is modifying the verb, the word it. It is modifying the word it. Here you can do some practice work. Whether it is adjective clause or whether it is adverb clause, sometimes it can be confused. That is why I have added some practice work. Let us try it here. Rinse those bottles so that you can recycle them. This part, rinse, verb, those bottles, and so that you can recycle them. And here, look, rinse is related to so that you can recycle them. So that you can recycle them is related to the verb rinse. Look, it is related to verb, not it is related to noun or pronoun. So here adverb, the clause modifies the verb rinse. So it is adverb clause. as it is modifying the verb rains, so it is adverb plus. Another example is here, the dog that chased me, not all dog, only that dog which is chasing me, amake je dhawa korche, the dog that chased me was a beagle. Here look, that part that chased me, it is related to the word the dog, related to the subject the dog, related to the noun. So you can guess what is it. It is adjective clause. This part is adjective clause because the phrase modifies the noun dog. This phrase, this part, this group of words modify the word the dog that chased me. So I think and I hope also that now it is very clear to you that which one is adjective clause and which one is adverb clause. That means adverb clause and adjective clause, both of them are group of words. But adjective clause will give extra information or will be related to noun or pronoun, and adverb clause will be related or give extra information or modify verb or adverb. Dear students, linking verbs, you should know it. What are the linking verbs? A linking verb connects or links the subject to a word or word group that identifies or describes the subject. A linking verb connects or links the subject to the word. That means subject will be connected to a word by a verb, and that will refer to the subject again. Those verbs which is doing the function of linking is called linking verbs. Look at some example here. There you have some fruits. The pieces in that basket, not all pieces, only the pieces which are in that basket. What happens? Looked. The part, first part, the piece in that basket, then you have got the verb looked, and ripe to me. This is ripe to me, three parts of it, and these two part is joined by looked. Ripe and the pieces have relation, and with the help of looked they have formed a relation here. So here looked is linking verb. And look, looked connects the subject pieces. The subject pieces is connected by the word looked. With what? With the word ripe. Ripe. Ripe and pieces are connected by the word looked, and this is verb. Looked is verb. As it is doing the function of connecting these two words, which is one is subject and other word is ripe, so it is linking verbs. Here, action verb. Look, what is an action verb? An action verb expresses either physical or mental activity. It will express the idea either physical or mental activity. Look at the portrait of horse. Here I am showing physical activity by this sentence. The horse galloped across the field. It denotes the idea of its physical activity. So it is action verb. Here gallop is action verb, showing the physical activity. Another, mental activity. How? We are studying the anatomy of horse. You are studying, you are learning, you are analyzing, studying. This is related to our mental activity. This is also action verb. So action verbs will give you the idea of physical activity or mental activity. And my dear students, you know bad and badly, they are very simple word, but their use is different, and we are looking it here. Look, Bad is an adjective. And here, the weather is bad today. Here we have used bad as an adjective. In that sentence, the weather is bad today. And here, noun, the weather. And bad is related to the noun. Bad is related to the noun. So, bad is giving extra information about the subject. So, bad is here adjective. Here tells what kind of weather. If it answers this type of question, then it is adjective. Look, another use of it. Badly is an adverb. Why? Look, I hurt my arm badly. Look at the word badly. Here, hurt is verb and badly is related to the word verb hurt. And it is giving the answer of tells to what extent my arm was hurt. If it answers this type of question, so it is adverb here. Dear students, you know, practice can make a person perfect. We have already completed all rules concerning to modifiers. And now let us see some practice work. Garbage is not managed properly and is scattered here and there on the dash places. Look at the question here. Your question will be this type in the examination paper. On the dash places. Here, pre-modify the noun. And you have already known this requires the answer which will be adjective. What will be the answer? Think about the answer. Open. Okay. Now, and they are on the open places. Open places. Open is here doing the function of adjective. And it is modifying the noun places. As it is pre-modify the noun. Places here and before. Pre means before. And open has taken place before the noun places. It creates odor pollution and causes serious discomfort to the sense of a smell and attract diseases use present participle to pre-modify the noun creature. That means you will have to use verb then ing. What can be? Look, bearing, bahunkari, diseases bearing creature. Here it is used as present participle verb plus ing. And it is modifying creatures. Pre-modify, that means it has taken the place of that noun. Other part of it is because of dash kinds of pollution, people are suffering from different kinds of diseases. Look here, the question is pre-modify the noun. You are using adjective. What adjective should be suitable here? Because of different kinds of pollution. Different, important, all these words are adjective. And it is modifying the noun pollution. Has taken the place before the noun pollution. And then people are suffering from different kinds of diseases and meet dash death. Pre-modify the noun, adjective. Death is here, noun. And you are modifying that. By which word? The word is premature, unexpected, or unfortunate. All these words are adjective. If environment pollution is not controlled, then people of this area will not be able to lead a pollution-free and dash life. Pre-modify the noun. Which life? Look here. Premature is modifying death. And here, pollution-free and dash life. What? Comfortable life. Comfortable is here adjective. And it is modifying the word life. And modifier, my dear students, It is very important and it is very difficult if you don't try it at home. But I have tried to make it very easy, and that was all about modifier. And I hope you have got more information about this. And that was all for today. I will be again here with my new lecture. Till then, I hope you will stay home, stay safe. Thank you, everybody.